Hello, so I thought I would make a little presentation here, and hopefully you won't make the same mistake that I did. I've been in the sound business or doing sound since I was a kid. I thought I knew how to spot a fake Shure SM58 microphone. I looked at a bunch of YouTube videos on the subject, and I've been piecemealing a sound system together from scratch for about the last 4 months. Buying both new and used equipment, about 2 months ago, I purchased a Shure SM58 off of eBay for about $60. It looked brand new, and they cost $100 new. After I received it, I looked it over, made sure it had the right color wires on the inside, and the element under the windscreen looked genuine. I tested it and it worked. I was convinced it was a genuine Shure SM58 until I purchased two brand new ones at Sweetwater Music, a large brick and mortar store here in Indiana. I set the two side by side, the fake one on the left. The first thing you notice is the windscreen. On the fake one, it's shiny. The real one has a matte darker finish. I weighed the two of them on my postal scale, and they both weighed the same, 11.6 ounces. The differences are very small. If you look at the connector, there are differences in the printing. Also, the fake one looks like there are two pieces of metal joined together on the bottom. The Shure is flat. If you take off the windscreen and you look at the top of the microphones, you see little circles under the foam on the real one. You can't see anything under the fake one. Also, under the element, there is a metal screen with small holes in it. On the fake one, the holes don't run straight with the element. And where the two ends meet is more prominent on the fake one than the real one. You have to really have them side by side to see the difference. Of course, the main thing is sound. Everything that you've listened to so far on this presentation is a genuine Shure SM58 microphone. On the mixer, all the EQ is set flat, and I'm not doing any processing of any kind. I'll now switch over to the fake mic. Now I'm talking on the fake one. I've made no adjustments and will do no post-processing. I personally have done testing between the real one and the fake one, and I must say they're pretty darn close. Proximity effect and directional. Some of the fakes get a buzz if you turn on the phantom power. This one does not. Handling noise is the same between the two, and I must say it's not a bad mic. If I paid $20 for it, I'd be happy. I would use it for karaoke. If someone damaged it, no big deal. The moral of this story, buy your mic from a trusted music store. Never buy microphones off eBay. If you do buy used, be sure you can inspect it and have the real one with you so you can compare them side by side. Thanks for watching.